The Supreme Court issued a ruling on Monday that'll make it almost impossible to sue federal agents. Wow. Tell me about this case.
This is a very bizarre case, and it's one that basically undoes a ruling from 1971, because the Supreme Court precedent isn't a thing anymore. But it says, listen, if you have these FBI agents or whatever federal agents it is, that violate your Fourth Amendment rights, mm-hmm. Illegal searches and seizures, you can't go after them anymore. Mm-hmm. Instead, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to sue the US government instead. Mm-hmm. So instead of taking an individual agent who acted, in a rogue manner and holding them accountable, you now, little average claimant, have to go up against the power of the United States Department of Justice. And I think we both know how that's going to end for the person trying to file a lawsuit here. You, as the average person, are not going to beat the whole DOJ. That's what they do.
Yeah, they can,
and it screws you out of your rights.
Well, they can put limitless money up against you. They can make it impossible for you to even show up in court. They can, they can handle it all kinds of ways, to where they put so much pressure on you that you just say, look, maybe it's not worth it. And that's what this ruling does.
It really does. And what it also does is it gives the green lights for any of these federal agents who maybe think like, I don't want to waste time on trying to get a warrant. Mm. I know now that I can't really be held liable for this. I'm going to go ahead and do this. We're going to violate your constitutional rights because you can't do anything.
I can get away with it.
It's the same thing we see with police officers with qualified immunity. Yeah. This is basically just expanding it to the feds.
Here's a ticket to go be a bad cop. That's what it is. Go be a bad cop. You have our blessing. Thank you for joining me this week, Farron.
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but all these segments are going to be available this coming week right here on this channel, and you can follow us on Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you the stories that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers won't let them, or because their political connections just don't allow for it. We'll see you next time.